context in terms of policy. 2003 new energy law said we have to reduce CO2 emissions by 10% in 2010. 50% by 2050. Hydrogen is one way we can potentially do this. It's going to happen in 2010. On the left-hand side here, you can see the comparison between storing hydrogen as a gas and storing hydrogen as a liquid. The problem with storing hydrogen as a gas, one of the problems with storing hydrogen as a gas, is it occupies a very large volume. If you compress it into a liquid, that volume is far less, but it will take a lot of energy to compress it. Now, if you consider the gas here and the liquid here and the volume they occupy, that's reduced even further if you can find some way of storing hydrogen in a solid. And this is really the way that one tries to go. So if one thinks about particularly the idea of a mobile application and hydrogen in a car connected to a fuel cell to replace the tank of petrol, then where you want to be is down here somewhere where you have a tank that's sort of lighter and smaller in terms of volume than generates hydrogen and indeed a lot of tank. Now, one considers the current